Ladies and gentlemen, may we have your loudest cheer for our Prime Minister, Mr. Lee Hsien Loong. 各位，请以最热烈的掌声欢迎我们的总理李。
Marilah kita sambut Perdana Menteri dengan meriahnya.
Ladies and gentlemen, let this place rock. Let me hear your whistle.
Lagi kuat.
Let me hear your chant. Thank you.
Okay, we sit down.
Cheers. 我们的团队联合起来就超过60年的经验。我们都知道，仁安乌萨集选区不是一个新的实证。我们清楚地知道每一座住户居民所关切的问题。我们这一组知道。 这个集选区是非常受欢迎的地点，各个角落有许许多多的新加坡人都会来到我们这里，甚至是海外的旅客也会到来这里参观各个景点。我们必须团队必须付出特别的精力来照顾我们这个宝贵的社区。我们都知道集选区内有许许多多的年长居民们。 他们逐渐的衰老了，我们也知道，我们的团体也知道，集选区里哪些组务需要建屋局、需要公用事业局、需要市政更多的照顾。如果我们没有这些知识的背景，将是非常困难来采取有效的行动来改进，来使我们的家园，使我们的兰乌萨的家园变成更好、更美丽的。所以大家千万要。 选择一个能真正帮得到您的队伍，请投人民行动党一票。虽然我们的集选区已经公布了5年市政的发展蓝图，以改进区内的设施，可是我们也知道，这些项目包括了有儿童游乐场、乐龄健身角落、有盖的这个走廊、新地铁站各。 各种的设施，可是我们也知道，我们必须播下更多的爱，更多的关怀，来推出更多的项目，来为我们的居民们服务，让我们的仍然才能真正的成为一个城市里的港埠。这个港埠是一个我们知道哪里需要我们特别的照应，以确保没有人、没有居民。 会掉队的。只要在我的甘榜格南美之路，我们和许多社区的伙伴合作。只要我们知道谁没能力工作，谁不够吃没有饭，或者没有足够的生活支柱，我们都会提供协助。爱心早餐、经济餐、每日分发的爱心餐。 爱心补习、牛奶尿片计划，都这种种的项目，我的团队的伙伴们也有许多有用的项目，让我们的居民受惠。所以希望大家真的要支持我们这一队，要投选我们 PAP 仁安乌萨的一队，很理智的投下你神圣的一票，投 PAP 一票。 Let me now proceed in English. the slogan to empower the future by Workers' Party is not helpful. It's not helpful if there is no future left to empower. To assure a future, the people of Singapore must start to make three important moves about your vote in the political landscape. Number one, start to use your vote to demand that all political parties work harder, not just the People's Action Party, all political parties. Number two, start to scrutinize, carefully look through all the proposals to gain your votes. Number three, start to recognize tangible achievements of the political parties through your votes. Use your votes wisely. Better politics in Singapore is when all politicians work harder, not just the People's Action Party. It is too easy for politicians to say they are not glorified estate managers, they don't want to take care of these mundane operational things in life, when lifts break down, when the books don't balance. It is too easy for politicians to claim that all they want to do is to talk and voice the people's needs in Parliament and pressure the government to work harder. Ladies and gentlemen, please use your votes to show that you too want accountability and action, and not just words or promises from the opposition too. Members of the opposition, in the name of better politics, must work harder too. Opposition members in the House must work hard not only at election rallies, but also between rallies. Politicians must not pride themselves by the KPI, the key performance indicator, of the highest number of parliamentary questions that they can ask. When political parties, as in the case of the Workers' Party, write in a manifesto that there must be adequate checks and balances in the system of government, I agree. But they too, every one of us too, must show that there are adequate checks and balances in the organizations that they operate. Other than filing questions at Parliament and making rowdy, great popular speeches at election rallies, what are some of the achievements that our opposition parties have made for their constituents, or if they're not in Parliament, for the people of Singapore? Those of us who talk about elderly Kananguni people, collectors and cleaners, why talk about it during rallies? Why don't we do something about them when we see them? Why not seek them out, help them, one by one, and then bring up in Parliament to make changes at systemic level? Why not bring up all these years in Parliament and offer solutions to solve them? Why only nearing or during political elections? If Singaporeans keep on casting votes to the opposition, despite the PAP government's trying harder, then you are just like the parents who keep punishing a child who brings back a good report card but is not 100% perfect. Arthur Conan Doyle, he's the British writer that wrote the complete Sherlock Holmes series. He said this: it is always easy to be wise after the event. We must all demand higher standards of accountability from the opposition in the House for the last 5 years. Demand more evidence-based assumptions from the seductive plans of those who say they have alternate government proposals for all the challenges that our country is facing, economic, healthcare, and social. Two, use your vote to start to scrutinize all the proposals that are put up to gain your votes. When big picture manifestos are put up without corresponding local level manifestos and plan, then either the local MPs do not know their ground and their residents' needs, or they do not have sufficient interest to do the hard things at local level. When someone advocates for CPF to be withdrawn freely without making provisions for the longer lifespan and the needs of our retirees, or even asking the opinions of those who prefer to secure their nest egg with CPF, then that is unbalanced advocacy and leadership. We have heard of the Workers' Party's advocacy to remove the GRC system and the nominated MP system in the name of political progressiveness. But why not the NCMP system as well? Because it is political advantages to the opposition. Because candidates who lose the elections, the best losers, they call them, they get to literally talk in Parliament for a full term, gaining a lot of visibility, asking lots of PQs, parliamentary questions, without having to perform any other substantive work. For the sake of our country, all of us Singaporeans must start to scrutinise proposals that are sold as magic bullet alternatives for political gains. Let us not be seduced by auctions and sell out our future. Scrutinise all proposals put up to gain your vote, Singaporeans. And last of all, start to recognise the tangible achievements of political parties through your precious vote. This GE, the PAP, presents its report card. For the last 50 years, for the last 10 years, for the last 5 years. The PAP is not a party that does no right. Amongst all the political parties in Singapore, it has tried and presented so far the best report card in modern Singapore. Remember job credit in 2009, when our entire country was fearful of being drawn into a big global recession. This government invested billions to ensure that Singaporeans do not lose their jobs. 2007 workfare for low-income Singaporeans. Just last year, skills future for everyone's lifelong learning so that they will continue to be relevant for the longest time. Pioneer generation package for all our seniors who founded this country who have a need for further security. MediShield Life Insurance, my favourite, for universal lifelong healthcare insurance for every Singaporean, regardless of their age, regardless of what condition, medical condition they are born with. Silver support for seniors who do not have enough to retire, although they do not qualify for public assistance. Ladies and gentlemen, these are all major achievements, applauded and supported by everyone in Parliament, including the opposition. Please recognise tangible efforts and achievements that are made by the political parties in our country. Through your vote, cast your vote for the PAP. I want to conclude, 1 minute. Vote wisely. The slogan to empower our future is not helpful if there is no future left to empower. This year, there were two departures from Cabinet. One is the demise of our founding Prime Minister, Mr. Lee Kuan Yew. When Mr. Lee passed away, there were a lot of tears and a very deep sense of loss in our country. Hundreds of thousands of Singaporeans mourned for Mr. Lee Kuan Yew. It was a surprise to some people because when he was around, the affection was not so widely expressed. A more recent example, although not of the same magnitude, when my friend Mr. Lui Tak Yew announced his stepping down from politics. As Transport Minister, Lui Tak Yew got the brickbats of public anger. He bore the brunt of much of public anger about our public transport. He suffered a lot of online abuses during his term when trains break down. But he quietly continued with his duty of restoring the train system. When he stepped down, the praises and the accolades surprised even him. Many people I met with him asked him blatantly to stay and not leave. Why do we wait till people are gone before we recognise their diligence and their good work? People of Singapore, please do not let history repeat itself. Please do not wait till the PAP is out before you say it is good. Stop acting as though the PAP has done no good. It's not true. Start recognising performance when it's due. Continue to encourage the PAP to continue to listen to you, to address your needs and lead you bravely into the next 50 years and beyond. Vote for the PAP. Let the PAP build a beloved home with you, for Singapore. Thank you very much. Thank you.